it's me. I always say KG, and my name has actually been on my profile for a minute now, but I don't think anybody really noticed it. So yes, my name is Kayla, and I wasn't really trying to hide or anything. It's just I liked KG because it's the KG lifestyle. But yeah, either one, Kayla or KG. A lot of you have asked some questions and inquiring about some of the products I use or what I use when I do certain styles. So I wanted to kind of give a little overview of some of the products that I use and hope it helps someone. The first thing I want to start off with is my favorite product. I actually have a video named My New Favorite Product. It's the extra virgin coconut oil. Literally looks like water. I'm almost out, actually. This is Dr. Bronner's Fair Trade coconut oil. It's virgin coconut oil. I found it in the cooking aisle at Whole Foods. And you can check out that video. Maybe I'll put a link somewhere over here so that you can check that out of how, you know, the consistency is when you actually buy it and stuff. It's my favorite. I hope I can find some more because I wasn't able to buy more than one when I saw it. So that's my favorite product. My other favorite products, and I guess all of these are really my favorite, but just so you guys know, Direct Leave-In Weightless Moisture Conditioner. This has like changed my life. I found out about this from Chime way before she had a YouTube channel. She raved about it, and when I used it, I was like in love. It is so good. It moisturizes. It applies to my hair. Basically, my hair loves this stuff, and you don't have to use that much at all. Like, this little thing will probably last me until the middle of next month, if not more. I moisturize with this, and then I seal with my coconut oil. So these two, like, are my top two, you know, products that I use very, very often. That's that. The other products that I use a lot are the Giovanni's Deep Moisture Conditioner and Deep Moisture Shampoo. Actually, I guess the conditioner is called Deeper Moisture. So, yeah. These two products are great as well. I found out about these from KimmyTube, and she actually recommends the conditioner, and I was like, well, why not just get the shampoo? Because I tried the Tea Tree Triple Threat, or I always call it Threat. I tried the Tea Tree Triple Treat shampoo and conditioner, and I didn't like it that much. I felt like it was really stripping my hair, even the conditioner. So it's really a clarifier. It's not, you know, a moisture shampoo and conditioner, but these two I use all the time. Now, I don't know if you can notice, but the conditioner is all the way down here and the shampoo is like all the way up here. That is because I am a co-washer. I co-wash as often as possible, and if I'm co-washing, I'm using my conditioner right here in this thing. I leave it in my shower, and I try to co-wash or wash my hair every 3 to 4 days. That's a lot, especially now because I work, and I know I'm not going to be able to hold that up. So I'm thinking every 4 to 5 days I'll be able to hold up that kind of routine or regimen. But I will be updating you because that's part of my updated regimen series that I'll be posting. So yeah, those two products in addition to the other two I just showed you. Now, this is a styling tool that I will forever use. And I mean forever. There's nothing that I can think of that I would want to use for this purpose more than these flexi rods. These have changed my life. Now, let me tell you my story about flexi rods. I had these for like at least 2 months, and they were just sitting there I had them at the bottom of my box with all of my hair products. And I just was like, I don't know, you know, I think when I first bought them, I tried to do a flexi rod in the back, you know, I was like testing it. And I was like, huh, I do not like these. I cannot get the hang of it. And so after that, I saw and I heard about the twisting curl. And I was like, well, I'm not going to go buy any more, rollers. I'm going to have to figure out how to use these. So I do my twisting curls with this. I do the twisted flexi rod set that I that's what I call it, but it's the Dorothy Dandridge look with these. I obviously just did my flexi rod set with these. These are great, and I'll show you in my videos how much and why I love them, because it's so easy. There's no clips or, you know, anything on the ends. It's just the flexi rod. You can roll your hair up, twist it like this, and lock it in. Like, that's how easy it is. And yes, you will see in my videos coming up of my styles, lots more styles coming, guys, of how I use these. Love them, love them, love them. The next product is this Lotta Body. Just used it for my flexi rod set. I just was really impressed of how these held my curls. Now let me tell you, this is my flexi rod set. It's day 6 and I'm dying, like, because I haven't washed my hair. But I didn't have time. I've been running around. Like I said, I just started a new job, so it just was not gonna happen. So I have been pulling it back, and these are my curls that I've been maintaining every night. Today is my wash day. Well, today I will be washing my hair. I'm past my wash day, but today I will be washing my hair. But this didn't make my hair, you know, crunchy, dry, nothing. It basically gave it a lot of body. Okay, the next product is this. No, it is not Eco Styler Gel. This was my whip shea butter, and it is all gone. And I have about 6 more ounces of whipped shea butter that I need. I'm going to make a new batch of. And if you have not seen my whipped shea butter video, or if you want to try something, you know, all natural, or almost all natural, I guess. I shouldn't say all natural, but it's basically all natural. Then check that out. I'll post a link here. Now, I'm looking at the jar that says Eco Styler, but it's actually whipped shea butter that I put in there. I use it mostly as a moisturizer, like a body moisturizer. And it's great for that. It is absolutely great for that. But there are definitely times when I have braid outs, or I have a twisting curl that I'm trying to maintain, I will use that on my hair. It's like smaller than a dime size amount goes a long way. So I'll use just a little bit of that on my hair if it's feeling extra dry or something. And I've been using, you know, my direct leave-in, and I've been sealing with my coconut, but it still feels a little dry. I go straight to that. I go straight to my whip shea butter, and it works wonders as well for my hair, because that's technically what it is. It's for your hair, but I use it as a moisturizer. The next product is my Eco Styler. I have this in my hair today. This is when I just can't, and I don't use this for wash and goes or anything like that. My hair is not wash and go ready yet. I've got that heat damage, so I use this mostly to slick down my edges. As you can see, it doesn't make my hair hard, you know what I mean, and crunchy. It does not flake, ever. It's the greatest thing. I love it. I have never actually tried the regular Eco Styler, so I don't know how that works, but the olive oil one, I love. The newer products that I love and I use are this deep treatment mask that I just gave away in my giveaway. I'm sure you've seen that video. If you haven't, go check it out. The next things that I love the curl enhancing smoothie and the curl and style milk in the organic coconut and hibiscus. So I've been using these two to maintain my flexi rod set, and they've worked great. And I'm very excited to use these on a braid out and see how they work on my hair. And I'm probably still gonna use some of my leave-in conditioner, my leave-in, direct leave-in, my Giovanni, but I'll definitely be using these two products to try to see if there's a difference or, you know, if they're better or whatever. That's it. And just so you guys know, like I said, the coconut oil and the direct leave-in, if you're just starting out your natural hair journey, these two are critical to, they were critical to my journey of getting my hair healthy and really feeling like my hair was nourished. And your hair will tell you, you know, if you put something on it and like 3 hours later it's like dried up and your hair just feels as dry as it was before, you probably didn't get a good product. It probably was full of water and all kinds of gross bad stuff for your hair. And this is all natural and organic, and I should say organic. I don't know if it's all natural. It is all natural. It's all natural and organic. Of course, this is natural. It's straight from the coconut. And then again, these are also pure organic. I didn't really have to try something and then try something else and, you know, kind of eliminate some products other than the Tea Tree Triple Treat. That's the only thing I was like, I don't like it, or my hair doesn't like it. But most other things, I just really, really did the research. So if you, you know, are doing your research and this is how you're doing it on YouTube, like me, like I did, then, like I said, the coconut oil, the leave-in conditioner, and get some good conditioner and shampoo. And of course, a deep treatment or a deep, deep conditioner. I forgot like my very, I love this product. Let me go and get that because it is that good. This conditioner is the bomb. Now, I compare this with Smooth as Silk. So these two I compare. I'm obviously out of this and I'm almost out of my deeper moisture conditioner, but this Nourish Spa from Trader Joe's is like $3 and it lasts forever. If you think Smooth as Silk is good for detangling, which it definitely is, like I said, it's one of my favorites, try Nourish Spa. You know, if you're on a budget and you need a good detangler that's all natural and is cheap, go and pick this up at Trader Joe's. I am telling you. And I have not used their shampoo, but I got their conditioner and I'm like, I'm a lifetime fan. This stuff is great. So when I get a chance, I'll pick up some of these. Forgot just a couple of things. Vegetable glycerin. You can find this at most health food stores or, places like that. You know, Whole Foods has it. I believe Trader Joe's might have it. I don't know. So vegetable glycerin, make sure it's vegetable glycerin. And aloe vera gel or juice. And I don't have any at the moment, but I use this, some aloe vera gel or juice, and water. Actually, aloe vera juice. So aloe vera juice, water, and vegetable glycerin, I mix up in my spray bottle. So when I'm spraying, it's not just water. Sometimes if I don't feel like refilling it, it is, but 99.9% of the time it is this mixture, which helps bring moisture from the air into your hair and onto your hair. So it's a great way to keep it even more moisturized. And remember, what's important when you're doing, you know, a natural regimen is to really moisturize your hair all the time. So yeah, I forgot those things. I guess we'll get back to the video. Bye! I know this seems like a lot, but like I said, the coconut oil, the direct leave-in, the shampoo and conditioner, and a deep conditioner is all you really need to start your journey and really maintain it. You know, you don't want to keep adding different things into your regimen because you won't know what's working and what's not. So keep it simple for those of you who are just starting out or who are having trouble with your journey. keep it simple, start taking things out of your regimen, and really just focusing on the concepts. You know you have to clean your hair, you know you have to condition your hair, you know you should be deep conditioning your hair, and then you know you have to moisturize and seal. That's it. That's my routine, and I'll be showing that to you, like I said, in my updated regimen series, but that's pretty much it. That's all you need. Thanks for watching, guys. I will be back with some style, so stay tuned, and I hope you're having a great day. Bye.